But first, it's a story that's shocked many in our Pacific Island community. Samoan actress Teuila Blakely became embroiled in a sex tape scandal with NRL player Konrad Hurrell after the video was leaked online.
And since its release, Teuila's been the target of online abuse, including death threats. In a television exclusive with Tagata Pasifika, she speaks openly and frankly about the last 2 weeks.
I think the subject of sex, specifically within Pacific Island communities, has a sense of shame with it, especially regarding women. And I feel like what has interested the public, the Pacific public, and I'm being completely honest and candid here, is the fact that they have an opportunity to shame a woman for being sexual. Okay, so there it is.
What were the comments that you had that made you think that?
I've had requests from Samoa for me and my whole family to commit suicide. People wish I would die and they would never hear from me because I'm an uneducated slut. Hold back, guys, you know, don't hold back. You know, things like that. But also, too, what's been, I think, really saddening for me is the amount of women that have participated in this kind of vitriol. I would never judge another woman for her sexual choices because that is actually her right, as it is mine. People also do have the right to judge that and feel how they're going to feel about that. That I absolutely understand, especially from our conservative cultural communities. What upsets me is the way they are voicing those judgments. It's like they're being so cruel. And I, you know, I haven't killed anybody. You know, there hasn't even been a community or public or cultural outcry when our babies are getting murdered. No community has come out this strongly about those kind of things. This kind of thing, however, has been so challenging.
You know, Teuila, I'm surprised because I actually was looking online for this interview and I was reading all the comments and there must be like over 1,000 comments of love there. And these are Pacific Island people. Lolina Avia, I'm proud of you. Kemi Sa'o, hope everything's all right. Shit happens, no one's perfect, you know?
Yeah, you know, that's something that I would like to talk about because it kind of, you know, when you're in this situation, it's really easy to take on the negative because the negative feels more powerful sometimes. But absolutely, our people, so many people have been so supportive to me and sent me amazing messages of support and acceptance and understanding. That and the true support from my true friends and family is the only way I've been able to deal with this as well as I have, because it certainly is something when you feel like the entire world is judging you for something.
How was it telling Mum this is what's breaking? I know that, you know, your mum meant a lot to you.
Yes, my mother. See,
what did she say to you?
She was very upset. She's very hurt. My mum is in Samoa at the moment. It took me, no word of a lie, 1 week to be able to speak to her. The story dropped on a Monday.
And it was Mother's Day this week.
And it was Mother's Day come the Sunday. And it took me that long to be able to have this conversation with her, knowing what was going on in Samoa, knowing how she would be feeling. The thing is about this is, sure, the public scrutiny and the media speculation has hurt, but nothing compared to how the only hurt I'm really, truly experiencing is the hurt of that of my family. That's truly what has really hurt me, and I'm heartbroken and sad about the fact that the community, well, not all of the community, but a lot of the community has you know, felt embarrassed by this, by their connection to me.
I think people looking at it probably thought that you've been dealt a harder card than Konrad has.
Oh, definitely, definitely. And that's also too, like, part of my admission was I was part of the situation. And if you're part of a situation, you can't just let the other person take all the consequences. And if anything, I actually knew that I would become more vilified for it than him. I couldn't just leave him out to hang it and go out there looking like he'd exploited some female. You know, I mean, imagine what that situation would have been.
Do you want to say anything else?
This wasn't put out there in a disrespectful way. Not by us anyway, by somebody else. And so please, you know, find the forgiveness and the respect in your hearts, because as Pacific people, those are the things that should define us, not our judgments and our limits and, you know, and our finger pointing. That's not going to do good for me, for any of us. So, you know, just be loving, be understanding.
Well, pretty amazing interview there. Thank you, Teuila, for sharing your story. I'm sure it wasn't easy. I think myself, I would have probably lied instead of come out and admitted it was myself. Mm. But she said, I couldn't lie about it. That's something that happened, and I don't regret the last week, despite what's happened in the media. But pretty sad to see the keyboard warriors coming out. We'd love to hear your thoughts on Teuila's interview.